Please stand for our invocation.
Gracious God, we thank you for this day, this graduation ceremony. Today is made possible through all hours of hard work by our graduates. Our support and guidance from their instructors, SLPOs, and staff, and by the encouragement and love of their family and friends. We celebrate the accomplishments of these graduates and pray that they will cherish this moment, both what it means and what it took to earn it. Bless these graduates now. This is our prayer. Amen.
Please be seated. Commander Pomeroy, Lieutenant Colonel Green, Chaplain, staff, family and friends, and most importantly, graduates. Welcome to the graduation ceremony for Machinist May Class 2139 and Electricians May Class 2129. Today is a special day for these sailors as it marks the completion of long weeks of hard work. I am pleased we are here to recognize the efforts and achievements of these young men and women. Today's guest speaker was born in 1994 in Washington and joined the Navy in 2014. After completing recruit training in Great Lakes, Illinois, he attended Naval A School, Power School, and Prototype here in Charleston. He served onboard USS Nevada, a nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarine out of Bangor, Washington. He has supported six strategic deterrent patrols vital to national security. In November 2020, he reported to Naval Nuclear Power Training Command, where he was assigned as an instructor in electronic fundamentals. He now serves as an electronic technician with Section Leading Petty Officer. It is my pleasure to introduce Electronic Technician First Class Submarines, Jaron Green.
Good morning and welcome to the great Lieutenant Colonel Green, Commander Pomeroy, Chaplain, staff, friends and family, and most importantly, I'd like to welcome the sailors here today in classes 2139 Papa and 2129 Mike. Congratulations on your performance to make me appear today. In every class that our students get to enough to absorb all the materials out during lecture perfectly, and they're able to perform well on every exam they take. These intellectual abilities will serve these students well in the our level of knowledge is highlighted in one of our watchmen. An essential part of our nuclear power program. There are some students that really had to put their nose to the grindstone and push themselves throughout their time in high school. That said, those struggles provided you all with a mindset that proved invaluable to you. I feel confident in saying for all of you graduating today who haven't had the easiest road to walking to this stage, that you will find all the challenges you had to overcome to prepare you for the rigors of naval nuclear power in ways you never thought imagined. One of those challenges was learning how to work in a team. For today's graduates, I know we've referred to you as a class during your time here, but in effect, this is your first real vision. You've been a part in the Navy, learning to navigate different personalities, skills, strengths, and weaknesses to achieve a common goal during your time in high school. It's a skill that will benefit you when you get to your first ship, and for many of you, allow you to become a more effective leader when you're selected as your vision's LPO. The tireless work ethic that many of you have developed will allow you to successfully tackle your initial qualifications and get to the ship. You'll find that holding yourselves, your shipmates, and your work to the highest standard that the Navy expects of you to be second nature. To tie all of that together, getting used to trying your best and hardest at everything that you do is the most important thing that you have learned in your time. With that mentality, even one sailor can change a division for the better. One division can change the promise for them. The department's performance and morale is a huge effect on the entire command. If you leave here today with that mindset and those skills, I promise that you can make the future command a better place. That said, take your experiences here today and apply them to that mindset of doing your best at all that you can do. Once again, congratulations. I look forward to seeing you all one day. Military members, attention. Graduating students, I will now walk you to the rank of third class petty officer. To all who shall see these presents, greetings.
Greetings!
Know ye that by the authority vested in me, through reposing special trust and confidence in the patriotism, valor, fidelity, and abilities of these sailors, I do hereby appoint you to the rank of third class petty officer in the United States Navy. As such, on the 16th day of November, 2021. To the appointee, your performance, moral courage, and dedication to the Navy and the nation. Which may serve as an enviable example to your fellow Navy men and women. Your desire to excel and to guide others must be boundless. Your appearance must be a model for others, and your performance must be a continual reflection of your sincerity, attention to duty, and moral responsibility. By exhibiting unfailing trust and obedience towards peers, cooperation, and loyalty to your peers, understanding, and strength to your subordinates, you will greatly contribute to the effectiveness and good name of the United States Navy. Please join me in a round of applause for the Navy's newest third-class petty officers.
I would like to leave you with a quote from Rick Warren. He's a pastor. Remember how far you've come, not just how far you have to go. You're not where you want to be, but neither nor where you used to be. It is my distinct pleasure to present to you class 2139 Alpha. The students made third class, Cameron Mark. The students made third class, Alec Leslie Asper. The students made fireman apprentice, Noah Bannon. The students made third class, Emerald Braswell.
Brandon, you bleeping suck, come on, say it. And So I did, let me terrify sacrifice with you when I have a 05 commander yelling at me, and I yelled, I believe you suck. He then went on to tell us that none of us were as good as we thought we were, and some pretty powerful language as well. 2 months later, I stood in front of the same captain performing my senior rank qualification board. It went very well, and the captain told me that I was to basically train all sailors coming up on their boards on how to conduct those and how to explain certain things to make sure everybody's trained well. And then 4 months later, we performed an engineering inspection, like Sept on the boat there. Due to some personnel issues, we never were short a qualified person for a junior watch mission. Having been a person with a lot of experience in that position previously, I was called upon to fill it instead of my role as a senior watcher. The lessons I learned and ultimately the lessons I want you to take away from this story are as follows. I felt guilty, even though I had no part in the mistake that was made in that first portion of the story. Because I knew I hadn't been putting forth my maximum effort, and I really wasn't as good as I thought I was. The lesson being, you're not as good as you did. Second lesson. Prior to that board I talked about, I had been struggling with my image, how I measured up as a nuclear trained sailor, and I didn't think I was going to do well at that point. The lesson being, sometimes, contrary to the lesson above, you are in fact better than you think you are, but only something. Third lesson, regardless of how you feel about yourself, as noted in those first two lessons, you will be called upon to fulfill the ship's mission, and you are obligated to execute your orders admirably without thought, given to ego, or self-esteem. That is the mission of the U.S. Navy sailor, ultimately the Navy. Good luck. And now presenting Class 2129 Bike. Electrician's Mate, third class, Nolan Adams. Third class, Matthew Chalmers. in his face.
Each of these sailors exerted a great deal of personal drive, overcame obstacles, and made individual sacrifices to be here. Still, there are those that, by the manner in which they completed their training, have inspired others. What sets these sailors aside from their peers are the consistency of their efforts, their refusal to quit, and the example they set. They demonstrated the qualities most treasured in the Navy, those of honor, courage, and commitment. These sailors are the recipients of the Commanding Officer's Personal Excellence Award. Today's recipients are, when I call your name, please stand and remain standing. Machinist Mate, 3rd Class, David Green, and Electrician's Mate, 3rd Class, Lysasia Sanders.
Use them to make good decisions. I am super proud of your accomplishments. Congratulations, job well done, and thank you for coming.
Please stand for our benediction.
I invite you to pray. Gracious God, thank you again for the success we celebrate today. Thank you for the wisdom shared with our Navy's newest ACEL graduates and petty officers. Grant them joy, peace, and honor for your accomplishments. Bless this path between now and power school, providing them guidance, safety, and protection. As we close in today, let us be reminded of all those who have come before us and those who will follow behind us. May you bless all those here in attendance, bless this command, our Navy, and this great nation. We lift this prayer up to you. Amen.
This concludes today's graduation ceremony. Graduates, congratulations and well done. Military personnel, carry on.